What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to a new video, guys. Today, we got the 335 here with us. I'm actually gonna be installing some roof racks. I've had these roof racks for a very, very long time. I got them even way before for my past 335 that I ended up selling before I was able to install them. So I've had these in my possession for about a year and a half now, and just now finally getting ready to install them. So honestly, just glad I can actually finally install them. The roof racks I ended up going with are some tulle. I believe that's how you pronounce it the correct way. Tulle or thule or tulle. I'm not exactly sure how to pronounce it, but from my Swedish friend, he said you pronounce it tulle. So hopefully that is correct. But yeah, anyway, we're gonna be installing those today. I guess first things first, let's go ahead and show you my car. So obviously I have an E92 335 that we're gonna be installing these on. And so technically, I believe they get installed right over here. I believe you pop these up and screw them into on top of the roof. So luckily these BMWs have these cutouts already, so that is good. My car is a little bit dirty. I don't know if you guys can tell. It ended up raining this morning, and here in California where I live, it gets very, very dusty. And then also the fact that it rained is kind of rare for us. So yeah, unfortunately the dust got picked up. Yeah, so this is the car I'm gonna be installing them on. Now let me go ahead and show you guys the actual roof racks themselves. Okay, so here is the kit right here. So I believe there are three pieces to the kit. It's even numbered 1 through 3. So this one is number 3. Has all the hardware and everything needed. But yeah guys, so here's everything that you're gonna need. Even has these right here, which actually hooks up the bar. I'm gonna go ahead, start installing this. I've never done this before, I wanna make that clear. So it is gonna be a learning process for me, but I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys the way I do it. It honestly doesn't look too difficult, but it is like a lengthy process. So I'm just gonna go ahead, try to mess with it, read this over, try to mess with it, and show you guys the process that I figure out. I already got a few of them set up. So kind of, it comes in 3 pieces for the, like I said, the Tula one. So this is not how the BMW one, the OEM BMW one works, but pretty much what you gotta do is it comes with like these brackets and like a piece like this. And essentially it sits in perfectly. I don't know if you guys can see that on video, but it kind of fits perfectly with how it is. So you just gotta click that into place. It's kind of loose, it kind of gets loose really easily, so, but it does click into place and it's being held in place. And then what you do is you take one of these, and there are numbers on each one of these things, so it is actually very easy. So like there's a number 20 on here, there's a number 7 on here, and then on here there's like a number 2. So you just got to match it up. On the instructions, it even shows kind of how to do it on this page right over here. Pretty much they are numbered, so it does make it pretty easy to figure out. Slide this up just like that, and then I think this one, yeah, like that, and then it sits perfectly in place with this rubber thing. And this is what sits on the actual car like this, and I'll go ahead and show you guys that right now. So you take this right here, and pretty much it's gonna sit kind of just like that, and then you have to screw it in. I'll go ahead and show you guys how to screw that in right now. Once you get these 3 pieces together, you're gonna go ahead, put in, there's these 2 like Allen bolts, and we're just gonna set those in there for now. And then we're gonna set this to the side. So pretty much we're gonna take this piece right here, see if we can get it focused, and the bottom piece is gonna be the one that screws in. So it has the shorter part. So we're gonna screw that in right here. Now we got it on there tight. So now we're gonna take this piece. So it's gonna sit on there just like that. And then we're gonna take one of these washers that come in this pink package. And then we're gonna take one of these little nuts right here. I'm gonna screw that on until it's snug, and then take this little tool that they gave us and make sure it's on there pretty good. All right, guys, so I'm not sure if you just saw what I did, but I took the actual main plastic piece, like with this cover. There's like this metal bar type of thing, and it has like the perfect cutout for these bolts right over here. And pretty much you just gotta bolt these into that back little bar, and then it kind of holds it into place. It did mess with something up here, so I'm not sure how the actual bar clicks on, but for now this is on there pretty tight, so I think we are good to go for this now. Like I said, I've never done this before, and it is kind of a learning process. The instructions are not very clear, so hopefully this video will help you guys to understand how to use this thing. Like I said though, it is a learning process, so I'm learning as I go. But for now, it looks like I got that piece pretty much on. This piece theoretically clicks on, I guess? Something like that. So it kind of sits like that, which it looks pretty good, to be honest. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and do that for the rest of them, and then install the bar. So let's see how it goes. Alrighty guys, so I'm gonna go ahead and do the other sides real quick. I'm not gonna record it, but when I'm done, I'll show you my progress. So far, I got both the left side on, the left front and the rear left as well. So these are both on. They're on there pretty sturdy. Doesn't look too bad. I just gotta figure out how to put the actual bar on. That part looked a little bit confusing to me, but let me go ahead and install the other two and I'll catch back up with you guys in just a second. Alrighty guys, so I think I figured it out. So before you put on the bar, you are going to have to loosen these two bolts, because this right here, once you tighten it, it kind of like angles downwards to lock it in place. When these two are loosened, this top part, hopefully it focuses, this top part becomes more flat so that you can actually push the bar through. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys what I did on this other side real quick. I don't know if you guys can see, but this is like angled down on this side. So I just gotta loosen these two bolts right here. The ones chilling right here, I gotta loosen these ones just a little bit so that this top part starts angling instead of down, that angles flat. So I'm gonna do that real quick. Look at that, guys. So this bar is now on. So what I'm gonna go ahead and do, I'm gonna take this cover piece and I think I can just stick it on like that. And then I take one of these locks, hopefully it's focusing, this little lock piece right here. I'm gonna go ahead and put that right over here. All right. So now that is on, that looks pretty good. I'm gonna go ahead and do the same thing on the other side. All right, guys, so we got this bar on now. It looks to be pretty tight on there. Yeah, that is looking pretty good. I think now I'm gonna go ahead, do the same thing on the back side, and then show you guys once I'm done. All right, guys, so we got the roof racks installed now. It is looking very good. I'm not sure if I'm missing a piece right here, like an end cap. I didn't see anything. I'm gonna double check, because it does kind of look funky that there is just this metal sticking out from this rubber guard. So I'm gonna double check real quick, but the roof racks are now installed and it is looking very good. I've always wanted to have roof racks on my car, so very glad that I finally installed these. I just figured out that underneath on this bar are where the caps are. So before you go ahead and install the bar, make sure to take off the cap and then you're gonna place it on the ends. So that is why it looked kind of funky once I installed it. I was curious about what these were for. It turns out that's what these are for. So before you install the bar, make sure to take these out. That was my mistake. Anyway, let me go ahead and reinstall this and put these caps on. So these are the caps. So technically the caps come on the bars. I did not know that, but now I figured out to my lesson. So I had to take the bars off of both after I had fully installed it. So make sure you learn from my lesson, take these out, because these are the caps for the sides. But yeah, guys, this is how it is looking. It is looking very good. To be honest, for never having done it, it only took me about an hour and 15 minutes, and that was only because I was actually recording the process. It took a little bit longer because of that, but realistically, it's only an hour install, and like I've said, I've never installed roof racks before. So for my first time, it wasn't too bad. I'm gonna take it outside and get some more B-roll for you guys, and then hopefully we'll get a roof box here soon, or maybe even a bike rack attachment. And I honestly also wanna get the fairing. It's like the wind deflector. I wanna get that wind deflector as well. I'll be on the lookout for one of those. I think that would kind of complete the look, is if I got one of those, but for now, it's not looking too bad. Alright guys, so that is the end of the video. Hopefully this was a good instructional guide for you guys. I honestly had no idea how to do it when I first started. After figuring out the first part, it kind of came together. If you guys are visual learners like me, I'm hoping this helped you, because sometimes those instructional guides are just not that good. I feel like I made it as clear and concise as I could. Hopefully you guys appreciate that. If you did, make sure to leave a like down below. Make sure to subscribe while you guys are at it. I would really appreciate that. Also guys, make sure to check me out on Instagram. I post pretty much daily on there, so if you guys want to stay up to date date with what I'm doing, definitely go check me out on Instagram. With all that being said, remember, stay safe, stay happy, and stay in that project car. I will catch you guys later. Back on deck on my fly, really on my, pay some respect to my mindset.